from Brazil, coming to us from Rio, taking on El Derte, Joe Dirksen from Canada. And Frank, you told me at the top of the show this guy may be the best in the business when it comes to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Yeah, best in the business definitely when it comes to Jiu-Jitsu. I don't think there's an argument there, really. Best in the business maybe as far as just as a fighter in the 185-pound weight class in the world. Top three in anybody's book, and anybody, you could really make an argument there for being the best.
His opponent tonight, Joe Dirksen, also good at jiu-jitsu, coming to us from Canada.
And Joe Dirksen's also black belt in jiu-jitsu, Canadian black belt, very effective there, well-rounded guy. More well-rounded than Apollo Filho is as far as ability to throw strikes and wrestling and jiu-jitsu. So definitely did his advantage to keep it more out of the jiu-jitsu realm and take advantage of the striking and wrestling.
There you see Paulo Filho from Rio, Joe Dirksen from Canada. This will be a battle of two nations, and whose jiu-jitsu is more complete, Brazil or Canada?
My strategy is to take him to the ground and show him that Brazilian jiu-jitsu is much better than the Canadian jiu-jitsu.
Jiu-jitsu is jiu-jitsu. I want to go out there and I want to win, and I don't want to win a decision. I don't want to win in the fourth round. I want to win in the first minute. I want to knock him out right off the bat. Get my cheeseburger and go home.
I'm going
to beat him up. Choking an opponent out or grabbing his arm and submitting him is very natural to me.
Look at my record. I don't have to say anything at all. I've choked more people than he's fought.
Much more superior in any way possible. I think the biggest threat that he's bringing to this fight is going to be his luck.
So this one for a belt in the middleweight division of the WEC. Will it be Paulo Filho or this man, Joe Dirksen from New Bothwell, Manitoba, Canada, coming to us from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. Dirksen looking for a little respect. Many people around Las Vegas say he's got no shot at Paulo Filho. Dirksen says he will prove them all wrong tonight when he steps inside the cage and makes his WEC debut. Frank, does he have a chance against maybe the best in the business in jiu-jitsu?
Very strong chance. Joe Dirksen's a very complete fighter. One of the more well-rounded fighters there are right now. Very good jiu-jitsu guy, very good at wrestling, good hands. There's no reason for anybody to really think there's a pushover fight. He is still a very big threat to Paulo Filho. If Paulo can have a hard time with him on the ground, because of him being a black belt in jiu-jitsu, he could defend and very well is capable of defending Paulo Filho's submission attempts on the ground. And he is taller, longer, and the better striker right now on tonight's matchup.
Well, he certainly has the experience edge. His MMA record 39-9. So this will be his 49th professional fight. Joe Dirksen now inside the cage here at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. He looks very much the part of being ready to face Paulo Filho. Question is, when they close the door to the cage, will he answer the bell? Here he is, all the way from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Paulo Filho.
This guy is really a leader in the world of jiu-jitsu. Three-time jiu-jitsu world champion, like a four or five-time national jiu-jitsu champion. This guy has really converted over his jiu-jitsu game from the world of the gi into the no-gi world of MMA. Phenomenal guy. Almost everybody I know that has a strong submission-based background, mine included, we watch tapes on this guy. We talk to him. We see what he's doing because a lot of us have formatted our ground games off of him. Strong, controlling, crushes you from every position he's in. Even when this guy's just holding you down looking for a submission, he's sucking the life out of you. Extremely strong cross-eyed.
He comes to us from the Pride Circuit. They fight in a ring. We fight in a cage. Is he at a disadvantage there?
Not at all. There's a few adjustments you have to make. And anybody who's a warrior of his caliber, who's fought at the level that he's fought at even in other events, and he's already converted stuff over. He's been a world champion with a gi on, with no strikes, and now he's becoming a champion here tonight without the gi, using strikes. So he makes conversions that are a lot more drastic than just fighting inside of a cage or fighting inside of a ring.
Paulo Filho has come a long way, and he is now inside the cage here at the WEC World Extreme Cage Fighting welcomes Paulo Filho. And our Tale of the Tape is sponsored by War, starring Jet Li and Jason Statham in theaters August 24th. There you see both men 29 years of age, a big advantage in height to Joe Dirksen, slight advantage in weight, and a 4-inch advantage reach for El Derte Joe Dirksen. So we are set to go. The paperwork has been filed. Both men have done their preparations. They are ready to go at it. We set it inside the cage. Joe Martinez has the official introductions.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Five rounds for the WEC vacant middleweight championship of the world. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, is a Muay Thai and Jiu-Jitsu style fighter. A veteran of the cage, he brings 39 victories and 9 defeats into tonight, his WEC debut. At 6 feet even, he weighed in officially 185 pounds even, and fights out of Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. Here is Joe El Derte Dirksen. Next, his opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner, is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu artist who also fights with a judo style. He is undefeated in tonight, his WEC debut. 14 victories in 14 tries. At 5 feet, 8 inches tall, he weighed in officially 184 and one half pound. Joining us tonight from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, here is the undefeated Paulo. Charge of the action, Big John McCarthy.
All right, gentlemen, I gave you instructions inside the dressing room. I want a good, clean fight. Five rounds for the middleweight championship. Do I have any questions from you, Joe? Any questions from you, Paulo? Touch gloves. Back to your corners. Let's get it going.
So we are set to go. This for the vacant middleweight title on the WEC. This is a tough one to pick. I could see it ending quickly, Frank. This could be a long, drawn-out, protracted fight scheduled for five rounds.
All right, here we go. WEC Championship, you ready? You ready? Let's get it on!
Joe Dirksen keeping the left foot forward to make it easier for Paulon to be able to pick that up in a single. Joe taking good command at the center of the ring. Not overcommitting on his strikes. He's going to need to throw punches and be able to keep his feet under him the whole time, well balanced.
Paulo Filho makes really his debut here in the States as far as MMA goes. He's been fighting a lot in Japan and in Brazil. We see him now in Vegas fighting live on Versus Frank. What should our fans know about this guy?
Paulo Filho is probably one of the best jiu-jitsu guys right now in the game, really. And a strong argument to say he's one of the best fighters in the world at 185. I mean, tonight we're going to be able to really be able to solidify that statement on how his performance goes. Look at that single, very powerful guy. I've trained with this guy down in Brazil one time in Copacabana. There was a choke that I thought I knew how to stop. I told him, nah, the choke doesn't work too well. He is so technically good and so powerful that he put it on me to see if I could stop it. I don't even think it took me one breath before I was tapping because I was going blacking out. I was like, no, stop. So technically correct, so powerful.
Big shot by Dirksen as Filho rushes in on him.
Good leg shot. Let's go. Let's go.
And maybe a little bit of groin on that shot.
Big John McCarthy said good leg shot. Keep it going.
Joe Dirksen doing a good job. I think that shows the 40 fight experience. He's not scared or overly impressed by Paulo Filho. A lot of people get intimidated right off the bat by people's credentials and who they are and what they've done and don't even fight them.
This is the same move Paulo Filho tried earlier in the round, shooting in on him and going for that single.
Now, Paulo Filho likes to hook up the head outside single on the left leg. That's why even the stance that Joe Dirksen have kind of enables that to be a little bit easier of a shot. He's going to go ahead and lift him up and slam him down in this position here.
Dirksen doing a great job of getting his base wide, avoiding that, pushing the head away. Comes up, look at that. Filho reverses on him.
Yeah, there goes a little bit of a mistake. Joe Dirksen threw that high knee, but he just didn't throw it with enough commitment. It landed, but not hard enough. And then what Paulo did was just keep the underhook with his left hand and scooped it. Paulo Filho passing the guard here, off to the side.
Is there anything that Dirksen can throw at him in the world of jiu-jitsu missing on the ground that Filho's not going to see?
No, there's nothing he's not seeing. Not at the level that Paulo Filho is at in jiu-jitsu.
Wow.
Great butterfly sweep. Joe Dirksen doing a phenomenal job so far. That was great. He's already gotten up to his feet after being taken down. That was the question I had for him. Are you going to be able to get back up to your feet? He said, my jiu-jitsu will get me up. And he's absolutely correct. That was pure jiu-jitsu that got him back up to his feet.
Well, this is MMA mastery right now. We are seeing it all. Both men respect what the other one is bringing. Theo locking him up. Look at that. Look at Dirksen putting the one hand and keeping it on his feet.
That part, Dirksen went for a head outside, the foot outside leg sweep, takedown. You see that in judo. But then the judo experience of Paulo Filho, he just hopped on one foot, reevaluated the hips, and almost got the takedown himself.
Let's work. Come on.
Well, for Joe Dirksen, 31 of 39 MMA fights have come by way of submission. So when he wins, Frank, it's pretty clear cut.
Yeah, no, Joe Dirksen is a very game component. One frustrating thing that I kept hearing was that, oh, he's going to get ran over.
Watch your head.
I don't know. I've seen this guy fight. I don't see many people in the world running this human being over.
Paulo Filho has this calm, just confidence. Now he's going to trade Leathery.
Nice.
Drops him down. Filho going calculated.
Look at this. He hurt him. I think he's out. Oh, he's
Dirksen
about to be.
Just trying to hold on here as Filho is just raining down the blows.
Paulo Filho just needs to go for a choke, finish it. Joe Dirksen is hurt bad. Paulo Filho is a short path. I told you this guy was strong.
Dirksen just trying to survive. There is nothing left.
Fight's
and Big
over.
John says that's enough. Big John McCarthy says that is enough. We were expecting to see the Brazilian jiu-jitsu mastery that is Paulo Filho, and he comes out throwing leather.
You gotta love MMA. The world champion jiu-jitsu guy just got the knockout on his feet.
Let's look at this one more time out of nowhere.
Yeah, just Paulo, not very conventional punches as far as what a boxer would say, but he's such a powerful athlete, and he just wings them in. This was just the finishing touches here. Joe Dirksen, admirable effort here. He's hurt, doing everything he can to get back up. Takes one more bad shot here. It just falls flat to his face. But, and see, he's hurt. Good stoppage. He did everything he could to get out of that, but it was too far gone.
Well, he was close to finishing out round number one. It is not to be. When we come back, we will visit with the winner. We will get the official decision when we go inside the cage live from Vegas. It's the WEC on Versus live from Las Vegas, Nevada, the city that never sleeps. And tonight, the action is fast and furious inside the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino just off the strip here in Las Vegas. Todd Harris along with Frank Mir, we said it inside the cage. That's where Joe Martinez has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, Big John McCarthy steps in 4 minutes, 7 seconds of round number one for your winner. And still undefeated and newly crowned middleweight champion of the world, Paulo Eli Filho.
Well, I'm finally a world champion here at the WEC. What does it mean for you now to have won this title?
Muito feliz. Não sei que. Muito feliz. Quero agradecer a organização. Estou muito satisfeito, muito feliz. Espero novos desafios.
He says, I'm very happy to be fighting in the organization, and I'm looking forward to the upcoming challenges.
Was the jiu-jitsu a little bit better than what you expected when it came out?
O jiu-jitsu dele era pouquinho melhor que você esperava?
Ele tem trabalho de gancho forte. Evita muito bem os takedowns. E realmente ele veio pronto para essa luta. Eu surpreendi. Agradecer meu técnico de boxe, José Destaque, que, pô, rafiou minhas mãos. Caso isso acontecesse, pegasse o adversário duro, com um monte de derrubar, eu conseguisse fazer meu trabalho em pé.
He said, yeah, he came well prepared. He was well prepared on the ground. He defended my takedowns well. And thank God for my coach, my boxing coach here, Destaque. I let my hands go and finished the fight.
Your champion, Paulo Filho.
Congratulations to the new...